Welcome back to Gundahar. Let's build a pirate bay. And well, last time we started to, well, relive this series. Because in the former parts, we already built a few of these houses and made the interior for it. And I really liked the style and thought, well, maybe we can continue this in the new century and maybe get it to a finish. Because we could build more, a few more houses around here and then maybe on top of the hill here. You could have a fort which overlooks all the area and maybe protects the city or the village here if something else wants to hurt it. And yes, as I said, we started to build this house over here, and I would like to continue, maybe make it a bit more fancy, adding some features to it. I don't know. Basically, we have the style of houses combined with ship parts like the hull and maybe the sails like over here. And these are additions which I really like in this style, and I would love to add here. You can also see we have a very flat hull of a ship here down as a balcony. And yeah, I guess not much else to say here then to start. Also, as a remark, I'm now on Twitter, so if you want to go there and get maybe current news and maybe want to retweet the one or other tweet of me, then please go over there and, well, give me a heads up. I would really love to spread the word and get Gundahar out in the world to see, so that people can see what we built over here and what we can do. So, enough for that. Now let's continue with the build here. So what we always can do is to add here some fancy stuff to the roof. For all, I would love to add a sailing post. So maybe not in the perfect middle, so maybe a bit to the offside here, like this point. We can make a sail. So I did it something like over this here, because it's a big house, we can go up in the air. And then probably, well, we turn it around, something like this, a bit to this side here. And then we build a flag, so made out of wool, of course. And especially with the wool here. We take white wool, and then we have red wool and black wool, which resembles the scheme of the flag here, of the banner. And yes, if you think hard, then back in the days where we started this build here, there was no banners around, so we only had these big wobbly sails for our use. So we can build something like this over here, maybe close it up with a bit of fencing, something like this. Maybe go also up here. How does this look? And maybe we could also add here some of these crow nests, which you probably know from various films. So we have something like this here. How could one build that? Let me think. I mean, basically would like to add fencing here, but like it looks a bit strange, of course, if it connects to the middle. However, we don't really see that so much. Probably on the back side will be then the ladder. Let's put that down here. Something like that, and then you can just go up here and walk basically around. Of course, there's not much space to it. And maybe we can even make a bigger sail post with a smaller sail on top of it. Something like this, and maybe just one black and one red. One to this. With a bit of fence, something like this. How does this look like? Well, it looks should be enough, right? Ah. We will leave it for the moment. We can always change it if we have a better idea, of course. And what I also would like to add is a small chimney. And for that, we can go down here to grab the materials, which is basically brick and smooth stone. So let's go up there again. And maybe somewhere in the back here, we have this combination of brick, stone, and slabs. And yeah. Then, of course, the good old trick of spider webs to, let me see, where's the wind going to the front? Something like this to imitate the smoke. Just build a crab load of it like this and then delete most of it again. So you have these small puffs of smoke, basically. Yeah, maybe here two more. Yeah. Okay, that's maybe a bit too less. Of course, there are now more fancy methods to make a chimney with a campfire, which really emits smoke. But it's also a bit more difficult to build it and to hide it, because you basically have to surround it. Otherwise, you, well, see it. And this is not that cool, of course. So I'm also wondering if we would like to put the... Yeah, let's put the ladder to the front, because, well, that's basically more what we would see at the end of the day, and not so much the back. So we have something like this, which adds a bit more flavor to it. Maybe one more higher. Something like this, and two of them to the top. Well, yeah, that's okay for the moment. Now it has two features of a ship, this little hull balcony and a sail to the sky. So the roof doesn't look as boring as before anymore. So yes, R. I guess he lost his comrades. Maybe they are venturing out. Oh no, there's another one. And the third one is just swimming over here. I see. So maybe they are the ones who own this place, or they just wait before they can move in. I don't know. Maybe we have to ask them at a later point in time. So, I guess we also want to make a few more additions. We could always make here a small normal balcony, something like this. Oak slabs to surround it. Yeah, just a normal fence. Something like this. Here another fence. And something like this down here. Or maybe something like this. Yeah. Then we have a small balcony over here. Of course, we also need space to go to it. Do we want to have something here? Or maybe even here? Maybe we can use this area to get the way to maybe other houses over here. So we leave this one as it is for the moment. So let's go down to the other houses to see what other features we probably had in here. Well, there's a lantern. I guess this was added a bit later by me. And of course, these fancy staircases, which don't go through the house, but along the house, which I also really like. The idea, you can see here a better crow nest than up there. Just a lot bigger than the one, but I also really like the one up there. I guess we leave it now for the moment, because it will add or get flavor if we add then other houses to it. Probably one more over here. And yeah, I guess we will see. We don't have to blend that much. We just can build whatever we like. So let's move on to the interior, do we? So basically all of these are more or less maybe some warehouses or places where pirates can sleep. So, I guess we don't have too much problems to make that. So we start with the interior. Oh, let's delete that one here. This is also not necessary anymore. We can replace that. So we have a nice big walkway over here. We can enter the building through this entrance here or go further to see what's coming next. Mm-hmm. It's also interesting. Maybe we can add here in the middle just these. Yeah, this also looks nice. Here we can add supporting elements so it gets a bit more depth. Also, like over here as a connection. Yeah. So it leaks, looks like it carries the weight of the above floor, and this is fine. Ooh, damn it. There's a skeleton dying as it seems. Well, be gone, skill. Well, maybe not. It has a lucky day. So let's put down more torches here so that we can get rid of all those guests we have. Because, well, basically, we don't like them very much. They are loud and noisy. And, well, wow, there are a lot of creepers. Maybe I have to turn off these mobs here on the map. Okay, moving on. So, I guess we... Ooh, damn it, they are loud. Use plaque stained glass, because I've seen that on the other building so far. That's a nice fit, I guess. Probably there are not really glass windows in pirate hideouts because it's quite the expensive material, if you think of it. And it's probably not lasting that long in such a place. But we can build it anyway. Okay. So for the ground floor, we want to build here some storage area because, well, it's pirates, so they have lots and lots of treasures. And I also really like the new materials which we have. So for example, these barrels. They make a nice place to... they look quite nice just placed down in various ways. Of course, even upside down, this is also fine. And then we can always add some chests. Also on top of it, like this. And it really, really adds flavor to the area because, well, we have now different tools to... Wow, what was that? To lighten up the place here. So making the interior got a lot easier over the years, as I've seen. Of course, compared to the 6 years, from the last point in time where I did build here something. Not that much did come into the game, but still a lot of cool things which help now really to make a cooler interior. So storage area, so we have something to place down here. Maybe you can let's make this one like a place to store your maybe sword or something, or your shovel. Well, sword, I said. Maybe they use iron swords. This is fine. And of course, we talk here about pirates. And what would a pirate be without a proper plant? Plant, did I say? Where's the flower pot? Ah, damn it. It's always hiding. Here it is. Flower pot is also one of the more interesting things to place down in a house. Yeah. So this is the entrance area. Maybe let's close one of the doors so we can go in here. Then you have the storage with a few chests in it. Not that much in here because, well, it's just a plain storage area, so we don't have to take care of it that much, I guess. There's also not much space left to place anything anyway. Right? Yeah, I guess. So, let's move upwards. Which is the more interesting place? So let's put down a little fence here. so that nobody is falling down. So, look for another door. I guess we can use here a jungle wood door. Also an IKEA, of course, for the window. The black stained glass. Also here and here. And you can see that we have now this whole area for ourselves. There's the chimney, so we could make the small kitchen over here. How could we separate it? I mean, a natural separation would be around here. So let's do this. Also placing down a door. So this could be the living quarter. This looks a bit strange. So we improve this look a bit to that, probably. Something like this. Also around here. Yeah, we can just make it like this. So it looks a bit better if we look upwards. And here would be a kitchen slash... Yeah, well, they probably also want to sleep somewhere. Yeah, see, the problems with these small huts and villages always are a bit tricky to combine all those necessary rooms, like a kitchen, maybe some place to sit down. Maybe just this area is the living area, because, well, they are pirates. They probably even don't know how to cook. So they are just here for the beds. So probably put down... Yeah, let's put down two of them. Maybe they did come around a bit and have also some bookshelves or crafting tables. Let's go for the bookshelves so that we have a small separation between the bed area and this area. We could also separate this with a... what blocks did we use? Oak wood here. Or maybe some staircase. So we have a bit of variation. So something like this. And then always those pirates, or if you have look into these, see these films, then they have the treasure chests right on front of, at the end of their beds. Okay. Light-wise, we can make then something like this. For the interior style, this could be added. Well, now the chimney is gone, which is a bit sad. But we want to carry this down. Maybe end this with another stone brick. So something like this. And then we can put down a smoker, blast furnace, campfire would look a bit strange, right? Maybe we can put down a smoker here. It looks a bit like an oven to heat up the area here. Then we would probably build some small sitting area. Or maybe we have here a small cozy place. You see, it's a bit difficult, but let's try to build here a bit of stone, so it looks like it also can heat up a bit, and you'll probably want to store some, I don't know, maybe some bread on top of it, so you can heat it up, and then it tastes like this delicious fresh bread. That would be cool. Quite good now. Where is the bread? Bread. We have here eggs. I guess this is food here, right? No food stuff is here. Okay, bread. Perfect. So it looks like quite healthy and delicious over here. And this is our smoker, so we can all the fumes go up and don't kill us. This is also good for us. Yeah. So I see we already got a bit done today. So we finished off the exterior for now and started with the interior. And that's probably what we are going in the next episode for, and continue or finish this house. So yes, as always, if you didn't go to Twitter, then please go over there, give me some heads up, give me a like, retweet something, would be really glad about it and like it. And that is to say, then please leave a like and then see you in the next one. Ciao.